Welcome to Learn the Sky. We release new videos every Tuesday where we will be exploring the sky one constellation at a time. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get notifications about new videos. Learn the Sky is also on Patreon, so if you'd like to support this channel, visit the Patreon link listed below. And finally, if you would like to study the sky in greater detail and need a guide, visit learnthesky.com to learn about free lessons we offer and classes released each season. Welcome, my name is Janine, and in this video we will learn about the constellation known as Cepheus. Cepheus is represented as a king, and it's an ancient constellation that the Babylonians, Persians, Egyptians, Chinese, Polynesians, Greeks, and Romans all recognized. The name is from a figure in Greek mythology known as Cepheus, and it was identified as one of Ptolemy's 48 constellations in the 2nd century, which was the authority in astronomy for many centuries. It's classified as a circumpolar constellation, and it's located right next to Cassiopeia. So when can you see it? Cepheus can be seen all year round in the northern hemisphere, and you want to look for a pentagon shape. The 5 main stars of Cepheus are of 2nd and 3rd magnitude, and whenever I'm looking for Cepheus, I try to find Cassiopeia first, and then I know that Cepheus is right next to Cassiopeia. This is the official star pattern right here of Cepheus. It has kind of some extra lines and stars here. However, when I see it in the sky, this is the pattern that I pick out because these are the 5 main stars of Cepheus. So sometimes I don't always see the little details right here of this star pattern, but rather I see a pentagon shape in the sky. Now let's review the pattern that Cepheus makes across the sky. Here we have the official star map released by the International Astronomical Union, and you can see all the constellations that surround Cepheus. So Cassiopeia, here is Cepheus, Draco, Ursa Minor, and Camelopardalis are all nearby, and these are all classified as circumpolar constellations, which means we can see them all year round in the northern hemisphere. Also notice that the stars of Cassiopeia are of relatively similar magnitude, but the stars of Cepheus, they're not as bright as Cassiopeia, so you want to use Cassiopeia to find Cepheus in the sky. And if we zoom up, here's a little bit more in detail picture of what the pattern looks like. As I stated before, I often just see the 5 stars and I don't always see these other smaller detailed stars, but this is what the official pattern looks like, and I'll point both out to you as we go. So here we have Cepheus. This is a great photograph, and it shows you that some of the Milky Way is in the background of this shot, and there's some interesting celestial objects there. But here is the pattern of Cepheus. Okay, it kind of makes, sometimes my students say it kind of makes like a house-like shape. Okay, but when I see it, I always see these 5 stars. That's what always stands out to me. And remember, constellations are man-made patterns. There are official ones that are labeled by astronomers, so we're all on the same page as everybody is studying them globally, but we'll all see something a little different. So here is one example of the pattern of Cepheus. Okay, here we have a few constellations in this photograph. The one that stands out to me is Cassiopeia, and she's seated right in the Milky Way. So here is where Cassiopeia is, and I always say that her angles kind of open up towards the direction of where Cepheus would be. So here's where Cassiopeia is, and then this is where Cepheus is. Okay, so if you can find Cassiopeia, you're likely to find Cepheus nearby. Just know that Cepheus is slightly more challenging to find because its stars are not as bright as Cassiopeia. Okay, we've got another photograph here of both Cepheus and Cassiopeia. Are you able to find Cassiopeia right within the band of the Milky Way? And then from there, are you able to point out Cepheus? So here is where Cassiopeia is. And then her angles open up towards Cepheus right there. So if we were to point these out, that's where Cassiopeia is, and this is where Cepheus is. Again, I kind of go with my own pattern. You will see this pattern a lot throughout and many other resources, but I try to always show both the official and what I also see. Here we have one more photograph of Cepheus, Cassiopeia, and this one also shows us where
Ursa Minor is as well. So first of all, find Cassiopeia towards the upper left side of the photograph. That's where Cassiopeia is. And then Cepheus is nearby, right there. And then you can use Cassiopeia also to help you find the North Star. So if you take that center star of Cassiopeia and treat it like an arrow, it'll point towards Polaris, which is the star that doesn't move in our sky, and it's part of the constellation Ursa Minor. Let's get one more photograph to get some practice here. There's lots going on in this photo. We have the Big Dipper, the Little Dipper, Cassiopeia, and Cepheus are all in this photograph, and even a portion of Draco, which are the five main circumpolar stars. So the star at the very, very center of this photograph, that's Polaris, the North Star. So from there, are you able to point out Ursa Minor? Right there, okay. You can also use Ursa Major, or this is the Big Dipper portion of Ursa Major. Use the pointer stars and it points you towards Polaris. So if you go over in this direction, this is where Cassiopeia is, and notice you can use that center star acting like an arrow to point you towards the North Star. So if you know Cassiopeia is here, Cepheus is nearby. So let's point everything out here. These are the three main circumpolar constellations that stand out to me in this photo. And remember, you can use the pointer stars and that middle star of Cassiopeia to help you find Polaris. And then the other constellations are here. We have Cepheus right here. And then this is the tail of Draco. Draco is a large constellation that winds itself through the sky, and you can find Draco by locating its tail, which is in between the dippers. So use these different strategies to help you find Cepheus in the sky. Now let's take a look at the celestial objects that sit in the boundaries of Cepheus. As you look at this star map, notice that the boundaries of Cepheus are quite large, but most of the celestial objects are concentrated in this area, and there's a reason for that. Cepheus sits within the Milky Way galaxy in this arena, so that's why there's lots of celestial objects to see in this area. But if we go back to this map, there is right here a star cluster that's visible. It's located near Polaris, so if you have a pair of binoculars or telescope, look in this area for this star cluster. Now, if we want to zoom in and take a look at some of the objects that are here, we have NGC 7822. That's an interesting nebula in this area. And then there's the Cave Nebula. This is another nebula that has some really interesting features that are separately labeled. And then here is another nebula called the Iris Nebula. So there's also about 10 open clusters in Cepheus, but most are of 10th magnitude, so you would really need something to magnify them with. There are a few galaxies, but again, they're all pretty faint, and magnification would be needed to see all of them. Let's examine some of the legends behind Cepheus. It is often the stories of the stars that we can connect to in some way, which can help us remember the constellation. The stories about Cepheus include his entire family, and there are a variety of myths about this pattern of stars. The legend we will examine is one from a Greek tale, but remember, many of the Greek legends were adapted from earlier cultures. So in Greek mythology, Cepheus was connected with his queen, Cassiopeia, pictured here, and then as well as his daughter, Andromeda. So Queen Cassiopeia, who was the wife of Cepheus, boasted of her beauty, which in turn made the sea nymphs jealous. Poseidon sent Cetus, the sea monster, to destroy their kingdom, and their daughter was offered as a sacrifice to that monster in order to save the kingdom. Perseus, pictured right down here, heard her cries, and she was chained to the rock near the ocean, and he saved her from certain doom. So all the characters of this story are located in the sky. We have Cepheus, Cassiopeia, Andromeda, she's often pictured as chained to a rock. We have Perseus, and then Cetus is not located in this picture, but is also a constellation and part of this story. Here is a painting called The Rescuing of Andromeda, and you can see everyone here in this tale. So we have Cepheus, Cassiopeia, Perseus, we even have Pegasus here. Here's Andromeda, and then Cetus, the sea monster, is located right here, or at least what's left of him. Remember that the mythologies of the stars vary according to time, place, and culture. There is no one true mythology for any constellation, just a variety of them. We've come to the end of our video about Cepheus, so let's review everything we learned so far. Cepheus is represented as a king, and he can be seen all year round in the northern hemisphere, which classifies him as a circumpolar constellation. The best way to find him is to find the W-shaped Cassiopeia constellation and Ursa Minor, which is also known as the Little Dipper. Cepheus is then in between those two. There are a variety of celestial objects that sit within the boundaries of Cepheus, but many of them, such as the open star clusters, nebulae, and galaxies, all need magnification in order to be seen. This is one version of what the star pattern looks like. This is the official star pattern, but I often just see these five stars right here in the pattern when I'm viewing Cepheus. This is a constellation that it took me some time to find, and that's mostly because some of the stars just weren't as bright as they were in Cassiopeia. But I always recommend that you try to find dark skies whenever you're looking for constellations. Your experience will just be richer when it comes to looking at the stars. I wish you luck trying to find Cepheus. Use the strategies that I taught you throughout this video to help you find it. Good luck and keep looking up.